It's only been a few days since the brutal killing of Inspector Subodh, who was chased down and pelted to death in the line of duty by a mob in Bulandshahr. Now, a second similar instance has come to light where Constable Suresh Watts was pelted by protesters in Ghazipur who were demanding reservation. When the constable went to the site to quell the irate mob, they pelted stones at him and he succumbed to his injuries. I am joined by my colleague Amir to get us more details on that story. Well, Amir, this is not an isolated incident. This is almost a consecutive incident in a matter of a few days from what happened with Inspector Subodh. In a very similar fashion, what exactly is happening? The opposition party over here is calling out the Yogi Adityanath administration to ask and question. Are even the UP cops are unsafe in the state?
Well, exactly, Samia. That's the case that is being raked up right now by the opposition against the government here. Because clearly over the last less than 30 days, within a month, this is the second such mob lynching, so to say, of a police officer by a mob of people. Now, in this particular case, it was actually the Prime Minister's visit, which was in focus yesterday in Ghazipur. And around the same time, several protesters from the Nishad community had gathered at various places in Ghazipur to send out a message to the Prime Minister that they actually wanted reservation for their community. And it was during these several protests that one of the protests actually went violent. And in fact, some policemen who were actually returning after the Prime Minister's visit was concluded, who were actually asked to contain the crowd over there to ask them to disperse, but a road blockade was actually put up by the protesters over there, and they reacted in a very violent manner when the police personnel reached there. Now, it was into this incident of violence and stone pelting that Constable Suresh Watts actually sustained serious injuries, because he was hit by a stone on his head, and he later expired while on way to the hospital. But clearly, the onus lies with the police. It seems to be actually another instance of lax policing by UP police, and perhaps the handling by the government there. Because in case more police personnel, a proper contingent might have sent there to disperse the protesters, they could have actually been taken control of. But in this case, again, the police was clearly outnumbered by the crowd that had gathered over there, resulting in this absolutely tragic incident.